Hello everyone, I welcome you all to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install Xampp in Windows 10 operating system. So let's begin. Now to install Xampp, you need to first download it. So for that, just simply go to your favorite browser and in here just simply type Xampp download, then enter. And then you'll be seeing this apachefriends.org is basically your first search result. So you know, simply click on that, this download Xampp. This will even open this Apache Friends official website, and here you can clearly see that they have basically three versions of Xampp. So so they have this Xampp for PHP 7 version 7.3, then also this Xampp for PHP 7 version 7.4. But here what I am going to do is I am just going to download Xampp for PHP version 8, and the current version is 8.0.3. So now I'm just going to click on this download. If you are using some older version of PHP, then you can just proceed with downloading PHP version 7. You can do that. But in this video, what I'm going to do is, I'm just going to download this PHP version 8.0.3. So for that, just simply click on that. This will, start downloading. I have already downloaded it. So, just simply cancel it and just simply go to my download directory. And in here, you can clearly see this Xampp Windows x64 8.0.3 has been, rightly downloaded over here. To install, just, simply double click on it. And now just simply minimize my download directory. And now as you can see, our Xampp setup wizard has been rightly open. So here just simply click on next. And these are the files that going to be installed. So what I'll be doing is just simply keep this all default and then just simply click on next. So this is the folder where this Xampp going to be installed. If you want to change your installation destination, then just simply click on this icon and you can change your installation destination. But in this video, I am just going to keep this all default and then just simply click on next. Now the default language is English. If you want to change your default language to this language, then you can do that. But in this video, I am going to keep this and then just simply click on next. And now just simply again click on next. This will automatically open up your this Bitnami website. This is just an advertisement. You can just simply minimize this for the time being, and then just come back to your installation. And here it's currently saying that it's ready to install. So just simply click on next. This will automatically start installing. And now just go back to this advertisement that they are showing. It's very important also, So here you can always install WordPress, Joomla, Drupal. These are all going to help you to create a better website. So I have already made a video on how to install WordPress in Xampp. So I'll be also putting the link in the description. Do check that. This will help you to build a better website. So for that, these are all very much useful, I would say. Now let's see about our installation. So it's now currently unpacking files. It will take a couple of minutes. So what I'll be doing is I'm just going to coming back once when it gets done. Yeah. So we'll come back. And now as you can see, our Xampp has been rightly installed, and it's currently stating that do you want to start control panel now? So for which I'm just going to check this and then just simply going to click on finish. This will automatically open our Xampp control panel. So now as you can see, our Xampp control panel has been rightly open. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to start our Apache server, and then I am also going to start our MySQL server. So this will automatically start our MySQL and Apache server, and my MySQL is now currently starting at port number 3306, and our Apache is now currently running at port number 80. So just going to simply minimize this and again go to our C directory, and then this is the folder Xampp where your Xampp has been installed. So just simply double click on it to go inside that directory, and in here we'll be seeing a folder called htdocs. This is very important, guys. This htdocs is our main folder for Xampp. So just simply go inside that directory And in here, we are going to write a simple hello world program, which will be, you know, our server-side scripting language. So we are going to use this PHP. Again, one more thing, guys, this is very important. So don't take this lightly. This htdoc folder is very, very important. You know, inside this folder only, we are going to create projects that, you know, we are going to simply run on our local host. So this is very, very important, guys. I am just, you know, can't explain much that how much this is important. So, you know, what I'm going to do is, you know, just I'm just going to simply create a new project. So for that, just, you know, simply click on new project and here, just, you know, give a project name as a, let's say, project one. Then go inside that folder, and in here, what I'm going to do is, you know, I'm just going to simply create a new text document, and here, you know, just simply go inside that text document, and here, what I'm going to do is, you know, I'm just going to write a simple PHP code snippet. So here, what I'm going to do is, you know, just simply going to echo a hello world in our browser. So, you know, after writing a simple hello world program, just, you know, simply go to file, then save as, and here, you know, just simply drop down this save as type to all files. Again, guys, this is very important. You need to save this file as .php extension. This is very, very important. Again, guys, you need to first save this file as all file type, and then you need to save this file as .php extension. You can give any file name, that's not an issue, but you need to save this file as .php extension. So, you know, just simply save that. And now, as you can clearly see, this prog file has, you know, this PHP file type. To run this file, you know, just simply go to your browser and just open a new tab. And here, just type localhost. Then slash, so name of our file is, so name of our project is this project one, so give that project one, and then name of our file is this prog, right? So just give prog, and our file extension is .php, then enter, and then you can clearly see this hello world has been, you know, rightly shown in our console. We can always verify this by, you know, just simply if you just change this hello world to hello everyone, and then again just simply go to file, then save, and if you just refresh this, you can clearly see hello everyone is in our console. So in this way, you can install Xampp in a Windows 10 operating system. So I have also shown you how you can run a simple PHP hello world program using this Xampp. So that's all for this video, friends. I have this website called geekyscript.com, so do check our website geekyscript.com. In here you will see some courses and also some blogs that I have written, so do check our website geekyscript.com. So that's all for this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like this video, then please give it a like and also do share it with your friends. Again, thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.